Hi, this presentation is going to discuss binomial distributions. And to discuss binomial distributions, we need to first define binomial experiments, which are probability experiments with the following conditions. The first is the experiment is repeated a fixed number of trials, and each trial is independent of the others, and that's an important point. And there are only two possible outcomes that we can define as success or failure. And the probability of success is the same for each trial, and that's related to the fact that they are independent. And random variable X counts the number of successful trials. So here is some notation that goes along with those characteristics of binomial experiments. N is the number of trials, number of times we repeat the experiment. P is a probability, P of S, that is the probability of success, while P of F is the inverse of that, the probability of failure, which is 1 minus P of S. And X, the random variable, represents a count of the number of successes in N trials. So if we have 10 coin tosses, then the N would be 10. And if success is heads, then the X might be 5, 5 heads coming up. So here's a couple examples designed to help us identify whether or not there's a binomial experiment going on, and based on those characteristics. So if we select a card from a deck of cards and note if the card is an ace and put the card back in and repeat the process 8 times, that is a binomial experiment because we are returning the card to the deck. If we don't return it, then we don't satisfy the condition of having independent trials with an equal probability of success in each trial. And so in this experiment, we are looking at getting aces out of a deck of cards. We do 8 trials, so N is 8. Probability, 4 out of 52. There are 4 aces in a deck of 52 cards, which can be simplified to 1 out of 13. And so the opposite of that, Q is 1 minus 1 over 13, giving us 12 out of 13 that it won't be an ace. So the probability of failure is much greater than the probability of success. So here's another example where we roll a die 10 times and note the number the die lands on. Each trial is independent, but in that example, there's more than two possible outcomes because we're just noting the number. We're not looking to, say, roll a 5. If we specify in advance that we'd like to roll a 5, then there are two outcomes, 5 and not 5. So this is the binomial probability formula, where the probability of success is equal to the number of trials factorial over the number of trials minus success factorial times success factorial, because remember X indicates a success, and that is then multiplied by P raised to the X and Q raised to the N minus X. And so with that formula, we can calculate binomial probability. So here's an example. We have a bag with 10 chips. 3 are red, 5 are white, 2 are blue. 3 chips are selected, and it's with replacement. Remember, we have to have equal probability with each independent trial. And if we keep any chips out of the bag, we're changing the probability as we repeat trials. So that's an important point. Find the probability that you select exactly one red chip. Okay, so we know that out of the 10, 3 are red. So there's 3/10. Express that as a decimal. And if we look at the pieces we need to plug in numbers for the formula, Q is 1, because we're just we're looking for getting a red chip. N is 3 trials. Q is 1 minus P, which is 0.7. So we can plug all of that in, and we come up with 0.441. Using the same example, we can also create a probability distribution. And with that, the probability of getting 0 red chips, 1, 2, 3, or 4 red chips is listed here. And we've got the probability laid out. So that's the binomial probability formula is used to calculate each of those separate probabilities. And if we extend this a little further, we can also figure out the probability of selecting no more than three red chips. So we would just add together those probabilities. Or at least one red chip would be this, 0.76, right, where we add together, well, we subtract zero from any of the other possibilities. So 1 minus 0.24 gives us 0.76. We can also graph this binomial probability distribution. And so we see it's here with this associated histogram for the number of red chips selected. And these are the formulas for calculating population parameters for a binomial distribution. The mean is simply n times p, the number of trials times p successes. And the variance adds q to that equation, the product of those three. And then the standard deviation, simply the square root of the variance. So here's an example. You have 1 out of 5 students at a local college. Say they skip breakfast in the morning. Find the mean variance of standard deviation if 10 students are randomly selected. So out of the 10 trials, we're asking for 5 students who skip breakfast. So we've got 1 out of 5.2 for probability. We've got 0.8 as the complement to that. And so we can go from there, right? Just multiply n times p, and also multiply by q for the variance, and then take the square root to get the standard deviation.